Now, before we get into this video, for clarification purposes, I'd like to properly define the term white Hispanic per Wikipedia, and also all population numbers cited will be coming directly from the United States Census Bureau. Now, let's get into the term white Hispanic. In the United States, a white Hispanic is an individual who self-identifies as white and of Hispanic descent and/or speaks the Spanish language natively. White Latino Americans are a broader category including people of Brazilian descent who predominantly speak Portuguese in addition to Spanish-speaking populations. Now, when you scroll down even further on Wikipedia, what you see here is that it says, as of 2010, 50.5 million or 16.3% of Americans identified as Hispanic or Latino. Of those, 26.7 million or 53% also identified as white. Now, many of you may already be familiar with Mia Panceto, better known as Soho Karen. Now, understand, Mia Panceto is a self-identified white Hispanic woman who violently attacked a 14-year-old black teenager after falsely accusing him of stealing her cell phone in a New York hotel. Mia Panceto would then go on to flee New York to her home state of California in order to avoid charges. Now, once in California, a reporter caught up to her and began to ask her about her violent encounter that occurred in New York. And this is what she had to say.
Any regrets about what happened the other day? Any regrets, Maya?
I'm good, thank you. Have a very good day. Take care of yourself.
Look, are you worried? You know the police are looking for you. Are you concerned about the warrant for your arrest? Why did you do it? You know, he's young. Do you have any regrets?
I'm actually 22, so I don't know what the problem is here.
No, but
and I'm also Puerto Rican, so thank you.
Oh, have so you're, okay.
Take care of yourself.
Does that justify what you did?
This white Hispanic woman is attempting to weaponize the fact that she is Puerto Rican to absolve herself of committing a racist act. She is very consciously weaponizing her ethnicity as being Puerto Rican because she understands that saying she's Puerto Rican automatically puts her in the people of color, minority, and marginalized group category, the whole black and brown, we're all in this together category. You see, this is why I've always been so adamant about black Americans, and more specifically, the descendants of American slavery, separating themselves from these terms. People like Soho Karen are politically the most dangerous people to black Americans because in their personal life, they identify as being white, and the greater dominant society will accept them as that. But the moment it becomes politically convenient to be a so-called person of color, minority, marginalized group, or black and brown, they will do so in order to gain the benefits of a history that is predominantly anchored in the history and lineage of the descendants of American slavery. On no level does this woman identify with being any type of so-called person of color. In her mind, she is white. But what this now exposes to you is why these terms like POC are so damning to black Americans, because you have people that are walking around here that believe in their mind that they are white and they are also accepted as such. Meanwhile, they get benefits, grant money, scholarships, and policy that's based off the backs of your struggle. You can't even get these things for yourself as a descendant of American slavery, yet others are able to piggyback off of your history by wrapping their perceived struggle around the history of the descendants of American slavery. And then you have the Mia Poncetas of the world who play the racial confusion game. Because as you can see in her Explore Talent page, when she was trying to get a job, she's white. Her ethnicity is white. But when I'm getting bad press in the media, now I'm a person of color because I'm Puerto Rican, black and brown. We're all the same. We're all in this together. So how can I be racist? I've talked about this racial confusion game in grave detail in my last video on AOC titled AOC and Progressive Dems Want Reparations for People of Color, not descendants of American slavery. Now, I strongly advise that you go watch this video in its entirety so that you can see these clips I'm going to play in their full context. But for the sake of time with this video, I'm going to condense everything. Now, let's go to AOC and the racial confusion game. When she was asked a direct question about her support for reparations, she literally responded by saying she doesn't know what black is. What does that mean, really?
But also, it does get into this interesting area of where we are as a country about identity, because like, what does it mean to be black? Who is, you know, who is black and who isn't, especially as our country becomes more biracial and multiracial, same thing with being Latino.
But when the current health situation that we're dealing with, of which the name I won't say because I don't want to trigger the algorithm, but when the current health situation that we're dealing with hit, now all of a sudden, as you can see in this article in which they're quoting AOC's tweets, she states that blank deaths are disproportionately spiking in black and brown communities, Ocasio-Cortez tweeted to her 6 million followers on Friday morning. Why? Because the chronic toll of redlining, environmental racism, wealth gap, etc. are underlying health conditions, the Bronx-born lawmaker added. Inequality is a comorbidity. Blank relief should be drafted with a lens of reparations. Oh, really? So now you're all for reparations? Got you. A little over a year and a half ago, Ocasio-Cortez was explaining her Puerto Rican lineage, and this is what she had to say concerning being a descendant of slaves.
I'm Latina. And Latino Americans have a really interesting identity because, especially for me as a Puerto Rican woman, my identity is the descendant of many different identities. I am the descendant of African slaves. I am a descendant of indigenous peoples. I'm a descendant of Spanish colonizers. I am a descendant of all sorts of folks. That doesn't mean I'm black.
Now, fast forward to the present day in the middle of the Black Lives Matter movement. And now that it appears that there might possibly be some political benefits to being black, when she's now asked a question about racism towards black people and racism within her own community towards black people, this is what she had to say.
You know, a lot of times I'll hear people say, okay, this is about Black Lives Matter. What about Latinos? And I always say, Latinos are black. We are Afro-Latina.
Oh, really? So now she's black, but a year and a half ago, she wasn't. Now in the middle of this health situation that we're dealing with, she's all for reparations. But over a year ago, when she was just asked a direct question about reparations just for the descendants of American slavery, she didn't know what black was. AOC has literally gone as far as to say that she is Jewish while speaking to a group of Jewish people. You don't believe me? Here's the video right here.
People don't know about Puerto Rico, and one of the things that we discovered about ourselves is that a very, very long time ago, generations and generations ago, my family consisted of Sephardic Jews. You know, the story goes is during the Spanish Inquisition, so many people were forced to convert on the exterior to Catholicism, but on the interior continued to practice their faith, continued to be who they were, even though they were pressured to not be that on the outside world. And a strong group of people, strong-willed, that were determined to continue living life as they wanted to live it, decided to get on a boat and leave Spain. And some of those people landed in Puerto Rico.
So now let's get this straight. AOC is a descendant of slaves, she's a descendant of Native Americans, she's a descendant of Spaniards, and now she's also a descendant of Jews. She's also Puerto Rican, but she's not black, but then she is black. And because she's black and Latinos are black, now we all need reparations. You see how these folks play these racial confusion games. But now in closing, with all this being said, these are just a handful of many examples for why black Americans, and even more specifically, the descendants of American slavery, must separate themselves from these terms, people of color, minority, marginalized group, and black and brown. And with all that finally being said, that closes out today's video. So make sure you hit the subscribe button as well as the bell notification next to the subscribe button so you can be notified whenever I release a new video. Also, make sure you text TD Hip Hop to number 33222. That's TD Hip Hop to number 33222. That way you'll get a direct text notification whenever I release a new video. But it also serves as a protection plan for myself in case YouTube ever gives this channel the axe. I'll be able to send you a direct link to where you can find me next. All social media links will be pinned in the comment section below. And last but certainly not least, for those of you who have been subscribed to this channel for quite some time now and have a love and appreciation for the work that I put in on this channel, the number one way you can show your support is through Patreon. For only $3 a month, that will help put TD Hip Hop Media in position to be independent of YouTube. Remember, the goal is not to grow big on YouTube, but to grow independent of YouTube. And until the next video, peace.